Hello children, how are you all? Today we are going to start the fourth part of chapter 6, the triangle and its properties. Children, today we are going to study one more property of a triangle, that is the Pythagoras property. Before learning the Pythagoras property, we should know something more about a right angle triangle. Children, you all know a right angle triangle is a triangle where one angle is equal to 90 degrees. Here in this triangle ABC, angle B is equal to 90 degrees. Angle B is equal to 90 degrees. The side opposite to the right angle, is called the hypotenuse. Here AC is the side opposite to the right angle. So AC is called the hypotenuse. The other two sides, that is side AB and side BC, are called the legs of the right angle triangle. One of the legs is called the perpendicular of the right angle triangle and the other leg is called the base of the right angle triangle. Did you all understand, children? Children, today we are going to learn a very important and useful property of a triangle called the Pythagoras property. This property was found by a Greek philosopher in the 6th century BC. So, this property is named after him. This property states that the square on the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares on the legs. This property states that the square on the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares on the legs. Suppose we have a right angle triangle ABC which is right angled at B, and if we take the measure of side AC as A units and the measure of side AB as B units and the measure of side BC as C units, then according to this property A square is equal to B square plus C square. Did you all understand? Children, do you all know that there are nearly 350 ways to prove Pythagoras property? Here I am going to prove it by rearrangement. For proving this property, I am going to take 8 identical right angle triangles, 8 identical right angle triangles and 2 identical squares of side B plus C and 2 identical squares of side B plus C. Children, you can see here that we are having 2 identical squares of side B plus C. Understood, children? Now, we are going to arrange the 4 identical right angle triangles in square 1 as shown in this figure. And then we are going to arrange the next 4 identical right angle triangles in square 2 as shown in this figure. Understood, children? That means the area occupied by these 4 right angle triangles in square 1 should be equal to the area occupied by these 4 right angle triangles in square 2. Did you all understand why? Because all the 8 right angle triangles are identical. That means the uncovered area in square 1 should be equal to the uncovered area in square 2. Understood? Since the squares are identical. Now, the uncovered area in square 1 is given by the square width of side A. So, the area is given by A square. Now, the uncovered area of square 2 is given by C square plus B square. The uncovered area in square 2 is given by C square plus B square. So, easily we can find that A square is equal to C square plus B square. Did you all understand, children? Children, I have written whatever I have explained in the previous slide here. So, please go through and understand. So, from this we can understand for any right angle triangle, the area of the square on the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the areas of the squares on the legs. Did you all understand, children? The above property can be shown in the following diagrammatic way, children. You can see it very easily here. Now, we will verify by taking an example. Consider a right-angled triangle with sides A is equal to 5 cm, B is equal to 4 cm and C is equal to 3 cm. Using the formula A square is equal to B square plus C square, we have 5 square is equal to 4 square plus 3 square. And we know the 5 square is equal to 5 into 5, that is equal to 25. 4 square is equal to 4 into 4, that is equal to 16. And 3 square is equal to 3 into 3, that is equal to 9. And we know when we add 16 plus 9, we get 25. So easily we find the left hand side is equal to the right hand side. The previous example can be shown diagrammatically also. We can see a perfect right-angled triangle is formed. You can see from the figure, children. Now let us take some more examples when the sides of a triangle are A is equal to 6 cm, B is equal to 5 cm and C is equal to 4 cm. Again, another problem, A is equal to 7 cm, B is equal to 5 cm and C is equal to 4 cm. Let us find out whether these measurements make a right angle triangle or not. This we will find it in the next slide. Children, by putting the values in the formula A square is equal to B square plus C square, we find the left hand side is not equal to the right hand side. You can see from this, 4 square plus 5 square is equal to 41 and 6 square is equal to 36. So 41 is not equal to 36. And in the second problem we have 4 square plus 5 square, again it is 41, and 7 square is 49. Again they are not equal. That means the left hand side value is not equal to the right hand side. Even after arranging the cutouts, if we take the cutouts of the squares of these measurements in the shape of a triangle, we find that they do not make a right angle triangle. This shows that Pythagoras' property holds only for a right angle triangle. What does it show, children? This shows that Pythagoras' property holds only for a right angle triangle. Also, if the Pythagoras property holds, the triangle must be right angle. This is the converse of Pythagoras property. What, children? If the Pythagoras property holds, the triangle must be right angle. This is the converse of Pythagoras property. Understood, children? Thank you, children. Have a nice day.